Try not to move. You'll only make it worse.
We're best off staying where we are for now, I reckon. The boys from the garrison might still be nearby.
Founder, I'd rather not bump into them again.
Look sharp! Thank you, Founder.
Enough of you out there.
Over here! Focal!
heavy boy.
I needed that. That's better.
That's all ready.
Sick him!
Best off staying where we are for now, I reckon.
Thanks for heeding the call. If only we got here sooner.
They've killed my bearer. I demand recompense.
And they called themselves
Oi,
our...
Oi, look country. Sharp! Must be the bridge. So shall the waters cleanse thee of thy burden, and bear it out to sea.
And now they are truly free.
I hope so. What of the Imperials?
A pyre was made. It's more than they deserve. We should go back. Cole is worried about Martha.
All right.
Best off staying where we are for now, I reckon.
What in the world is going?
No one survived then.
I'm sorry. Before he passed, one of them bade me tell you not to blame yourself.
Doesn't mean I won't. Doesn't mean their blood's not on my hands. Cole said you cast their remains. That was good of you. But it should have been me. This was all my fault.
How? You couldn't have known.
But I did. And I turned a deaf ear to the warnings like the fool I am. The rumors started moons ago of black-clad devils descending on villages in the dead of night to slit the throats of sleeping bearers. I assumed it was all just nonsense concocted by the Empire. Nothing but a ghost story meant to make folk think twice about lending a hand to a fugitive bearer.
And in ordinary times, you would have been right. What these black shields are doing is unthinkable. Which begs the question, why do it at all? My mother obviously has a hand in this. I cannot make sense of her actions.
And picking what goes on in that woman's head is a job for someone with more time on their hands. Right now, I need swords and men to wield them, preferably big ones. If those Imperials think they can come in here again and threaten my people, they're in for a rude awakening. Oh, before I forget, a Stolas from Otto landed just before you arrived. He asked me to tell you that Gav has returned.
Then we must as well. Will you be all right here, Martha?
We can stay longer if you wish.
No need. I'll be ready should the Imperials come calling. Though I wouldn't turn my nose up if you were to lend me a pair of them strapping young Cursebreakers.
Now, where's Gav?
I hear there's trouble.
But none of the Cursebreakers have returned.
They'll be fine. Sid wouldn't be here if they weren't.
Ah, Clive! How I've missed that scowl.
Where's my report?
What, no kind words for your old pal Gav?
If it's kind words you're after, you're fishing in the wrong barrel. Now sit down, you fool.
So, you remember how quick the Empire was to occupy the Dominion after the fall of Drake's Head? And how pissed off all the other nations were that they didn't think to do it first.
Half a century of independence gone at the whim of a madman. So much for their bloody treaty.
Clearly, the promise of unblighted land and the world's supply of crystals was too much for his radiance to resist. And now the Republic's finally decided to follow suit, using liberation as an excuse to declare war on Sambrek. Lined up right outside the Dominion's gates as we speak, looking to starve the Imperials into submission.
And now all eyes are on the Strait of Ortha.
While the two nations beat their shields, the rest sharpen their daggers, ready to set upon the war-weary victor. They'll never see us coming. It's time we moved on the Mother Crystals. Four Mother Crystals remain in Storm and Ash. Drake's Breath, near Ironhome. Drake's Fang, in Dalmechia. Drake's Spine, in Walud. And Drake's Tail, here in the Crystalline Dominion.
With the bulk of the Republican army marching to Twinside, Drake's Fang will be left exposed.
That is exactly the move Kupka would anticipate. And if there is anything these past 5 years have taught us, is that he loves his traps. There is one place, however, where nobody will be expecting us to go.
Drake's Breath.
There's a shitload of sea between us and it, and I've never been much of a swimmer.
I have an acquaintance in Port Isolde who may be able to help.
Who's that then?
My uncle. Byron Rossfield.
Lord Byron Rossfield of the Seven High Houses, the trade magnate with holdings in over 100 cities. Wait. Rossfield. And you're a Rossfield, of course.
My uncle's name gave him his start in the world, but it was his acumen which earned him his fortune. Along with a handsome fleet of ships.
Well, it's settled then. What are we waiting for, eh? Huh?
What are we waiting for, indeed?
Do you think it was wise to leave, Gav? He didn't seem pleased.
I needed his eyes and nose in Dalmechia. I'm not about to let Kupka take us unawares. Besides, he has a knack for that sort of thing.
That he does.
And wasn't it Cid who said that matters such as these are best left to Dominance? Especially should one of his beloved opportunities to grow and change present itself.
I always knew that I would return one day. Return to Ironhome.
For what?
After learning the truth, you were given the chance to face your past. If I am to continue at your side, I must do the same.
We will face it together then.
To the end. How far do you think your mother's reach extends? Will we find the same tragedy in the south as we did at Martha's Rest?
More than likely. Which is why we should hurry. There are still many settlements between here and Port Isolde. We visit as many as we can and hear their stories. Starting with the village of Amber.
Justice is what it is. Lord Elwyn would never have stood for this.
Quiet, you! I think we're loyalists.
Jill, look.
Rosaria must be cleansed of the stain which befouls her, that she might rise once again from the ashes to welcome a new dawn. T'would be a pity to make examples of you all for the transgressions of but a handful.
Of course, your lordship. You shall have our full cooperation.
What business could the Black Shields have in a village this small? There's barely room to hide a bearer.
Then they must be here for something else.
You fancy dancing a gallows jig like the miller's son?
All right. I heard you the first time.
Excuse me, but what was all that about earlier?
You haven't heard? Someone's been stirring up trouble. There have been attacks on a garrison, supplies stolen. They even say a Black Shield was murdered. The Empire wants answers, and what the Empire wants, Empire gets.
Don't they just?
Keep your ears open, eh? The Black Shields will pay good coin for information on the culprits. You'd have to be dull as a sack of stones to think you could take on the Empire. What with their 100 full legions?
100? I heard it were 1,000.
You seen them, didn't you?
I'm sorry.
The black shields. Just now. You seen them, didn't you? At least I think there was a black shield. Can't say I ever saw one before.
Was this the first time they visited the village?
What do you think? Amber's the arse end of nowhere. And they thought we might be harboring firebrands. Huh. If only we were. I might have turned them in and become a black shield myself.
You don't think these firebrands the Empire is looking for could be us, do you?
I don't know.
How'd you get it?
But we need to find out.
Join the garrison this very morn.
At this rate, there'll be none left to help with the harvest.
Word is, Port Isolde's closed her gates to all but the Highborn, and now a great camp sprung up along the walls.
Greetings, friend. We are travelers.
I know that. What do you want?
We couldn't help noticing those Imperial soldiers who were here earlier.
Don't you go telling these strangers a thing. I speak for the people of this village, and we have nothing more to say to you. You are to leave Amber and never come back.
May I at least ask why?
I don't know who you are or what brings you here, but your presence puts us all in grave danger. The Empire is a harsh master. Its demands are great, and its justice swift. But as long as we keep our heads down and pay our tributes, we are left alone. Some might call it submission. But if it will spare my people the Viceroy's wrath, then I will gladly submit. This village will not become another East Pole.
Then we shall be on our way. These people live with a knife to their throat. In the mistaken belief that if they cooperate, my mother will show them mercy.
Obedience bought with fear.
Are you all right?
Sorry, it's nothing. We still don't know who the Black Shields are looking for.
Well, whoever they are, the Imperials deem them worth pursuing to the back of beyond. But other than Martha, who else in Rosari would have the courage to stand against the Empire? A new ally would certainly be welcome. Can we find them before the Imperials do? Perhaps the next village will yield more answers.
Perhaps.
This pass will take us through the mountains.
And directly into the path of whoever or whatever lurks here.
Ever since the apodatory, I've seen more and more of these echoes.
What do you think is waking him? The mother crystals collapsed.
I have an idea. You're not going to like it.
Blood, Clive.
And still wet.
You were told to stay in your homes.
The Black Shields.
You know who we are. And still, you would bear your steel. Why then? We owe you our thanks. You have saved us the trouble of an interrogation. To dwell in darkness, that we may purge the night and welcome lasting dawn. On these, our swords we swear.
Say that again. I'll show you a true shield of Rosaria. Get him! This one!
Let's go.
get him!
Tell me what I want and the end will be swift. Who are you looking for?
Why, you. We come bearing a message. Your friends have been found. The branded you freed from our camps. They await you in Ordeal. Guardians of the Flame.
Those are Old Hill's gates.
Then we hurry. That's better. Something, boy. Death.
Oh, found her.
This was my mother's doing.
But why? Why would anyone?
I don't know. I never truly understood her. But this...
Oh, Clive.
Drives her, and I will end it. We should go.
Yes.
We can't leave them here like this.
We won't. But if the Black Shields have made it this far south, they may already be in Port Isolde.
They're approaching Bewit Bridge. Though I doubt the Empire would let us cross over to Rosalith.
This one.
They're all Rosarian.
But this is their home.
Lazarus, what happened to this place?
My mother happened. The nobles who lived here didn't stand a chance. Let's hope my uncle fared better.
This one. Go for it. That's the main gate.
And it looks like we're not the only ones hoping to get in.
Let us pass!
My children are starving!
Have mercy!
Voicefriend's dogs, they are! You can't ignore us forever!
Let us in, or we'll die on your doorstep!
Better out there than in here!
No, enough for us!
Fuck off!
I'm the chinless bastards! Those crystals belong to us all!
I said,
where were you, filth?
Back to your stall! We'll cut you down where you stand!
Just try it!
No chance of slipping through unnoticed. We'll need to find another way in. I thought we might be able to reason with the guards. Or at least bribe them.
I suspect everyone in that crowd thought the same. Was that the only way in?
Officially, yes. Strictly speaking, no. My uncle once told me that the nobles had tunnels built so that they could visit town without having to walk amongst the rabble. The Lazarus. We'll find our way into the city there.
If you're sure. The entire place looked abandoned. Do you think it's safe?
As long as it is abandoned.
The good news is we haven't seen a single black shield since Oldhill.
Maybe they found who they were looking for. This is nothing like I remember it.
How quickly a crown can lose its luster.
Not abandoned, then.
Oi! Visitors!
Apologies. We'll show ourselves out.
Ha!
I've only ever seen one man fight like that. And he's long dead.
Then perhaps it's time you joined him.
The blessing of the Phoenix. It can't be. I was there when you died. Forgive me, my lord. I knew not whom I addressed. You have naught to fear from us. Founder, it really is you.
It is. So wait.
We can speak inside.
And those who wouldn't bend the knee?
We left before the Empire could make examples of us, though we didn't go far. And we banded together to form the Guardians of the Flame soon after. Alas, there is only so much a handful of aging shields can do against the might of an empire. But we've seen to it that their stay has been anything but pleasant. Of late, though, we've had our hands full just trying to keep the Duchy's few remaining bearers out of the Imperial's clutches.
The Cullings. We saw what happened in Old Hill.
Aye. The foul work of the Black Shields and their mistress.
You mean my mother? But it doesn't make sense. Even knowing what I know about her. Her hatred for bearers was no secret, but she wouldn't have been ignorant of their value to the realm.
No offense, my lord, but in case you haven't noticed, the Lady Annabella couldn't care less about the realm. She barely even cares for her own home. That much has been plain since the slaughter at Eastpool. And since granting the Holy Emperor a new heir, her obsession with bearers only seems to have grown. As to why, I don't know. Maybe she can't bear the thought of anyone having the power to challenge her beloved son.
Her son.
Sir Wade, the Black Shields have broken camp. They march in full force for Bewick Bridge.
Then so do we. Make ready. This is their main host. If we remove the head, perhaps we can prevent what happened at the docks from happening somewhere else. If I do nothing, then the blood of their next victims will be on my hands.
Yours and ours. We too have witnessed the crimes these men who dare call themselves Shields have committed in my mother's name. It cannot be allowed to continue. We must put a stop to this madness.
We must. So let us go with you. For the good of Rosaria.
I was hoping you'd say that. Very well. If that is your wish, I would be honored to serve at your side.
And we at yours.
Sir Wade, let us do our duty.
With pleasure, my lord.
I imagine this endeavor will require more than just our wits.
Then let's hope Sir Wade has a good quartermaster.
Thank you.
telling me that's the Archduke's son?
We'll show them as much mercy as they did our sisters and brothers in Old Hill.
Less.
Tell us then, Sir Wade. What is your plan?
Nothing fancy. You, Lady Jill, and I make for Buett Bridge and provoke the main host at their encampment. Sensing an opportunity to end the Guardians, the Black Shields will call for reinforcements, who will be met from the rear by parties of my brothers hidden throughout the surrounding hills. This will allow us to wage battle on the bridge without fear of being overwhelmed. While the Black Shields have an advantage in numbers, you see, they prefer to fight in small units, which we can use to our advantage.
How small exactly?
Small enough, now that I have you and Lady Jill for company. I doubt I could have done this on my own.
But until we arrived, that was your plan. You haven't changed a bit.
So, Wade. The bearers from Old Hill have been laid to rest.
Very good. Now make ready for battle.
As you command.
Thank you, Sir Wade. Perhaps now they will find peace.
There is but one thing which will grant them peace. Putting an end to the Black Shields.
And so we shall.
Blessing of the Phoenix go with you.
How long have you been pursuing the Black Shields?
Since they burned their first village. We tracked down the bastards responsible and fed their corpses to Stillwind. Suffice to say, that got their attention. It's been a game of cat and mouse ever since. On your command, my lord.
What is it now? I told you!
We bear a message for the Viceroy. From the Guardians of the Flame.
Ha! You presume to tell us that a pair of filthy vagabonds, a woman and a dog, could guard aught against the might of the Black Shields? Then come! Die along with your flame! For Azaria!
For Azaria!
Your petty revolution ends here. On these our swords, we swear. Get him.
This one.
Get him. Over here.
Bloody hell!
Reinforcements from the far bank!
the Wyvern to fight their battle for them.
A noble stand, albeit a misguided one. In taking it, you have but proven our point, that this land is in dire need of cleansing.
Go for it.
You're telling me that's the Archduke's son?
In the flesh. Saw him once when I was your age. He had that same look in his eyes.
Show them
back
the
up, man.
Fire in
at least
our
you're
hearts.
Not dead.
It's not so easily quenched. Black shields? Oh, what hit them?
May the blessing of the Phoenix go with you.
What is it now? I told you!
We bear a message for the Vicerine. From the Guardians of the Flame.
Ha! You presume to tell us that a pair of filthy vagabonds, a woman and a dog, could guard aught against the might of the Black Shields? Then come! Die along with your flame! For us area!
For us area!
Your petty revolution ends here. On these our swords we swear. This one.
This one. Go for it! A noble stand, albeit a misguided one. In taking it, you have but proven our point, that this land is in dire need of cleansing.
You're telling me that's the Archduke's son?
In the flesh. Saw him once when I was your age. He had that same look in his eyes.
You are welcome to what little we have managed to salvage. Will that be all? May the blessing of the crystals go with you.
Blessing of the Phoenix go with you.
What is it now? I told you!
We bear a message for the Viceroy. From the Guardians of the Flame.
Ha! You presume to tell us that a pair of filthy vagabonds, a woman and a dog, could guard aught against the might of the Black Shields? Then come! Die along with your flame! For us area!
For us area!
Your petty revolution ends here. On these our swords we swear.
Bloody hell! Reinforcements from the far bank!
Another wyvern to fight their battle for them.
Aren't taking any chances. I can't be flattered.
A noble stand, albeit a misguided one. In taking it, you have but proven our point, that this land is in dire need of cleansing.
You're telling me that's the Archduke's son?
In the flesh. Saw him once when I was your age. He had that same look in his eyes.
We'll show him as much mercy as...
May the blessing of the Phoenix go with you.
Sideways.
How was the plan? Come along.
The bastards are lucky.
What is it now? I told you!
We bear a message for the Vicerine. From the Guardians of the Flame.
Ha! You presume to tell us that a pair of filthy vagabonds, a woman and a dog, could guard aught against the might of the Black Shields? Then come! Die along with your flame! For us area!
For us area!
Your petty revolution ends here. On these our swords we swear.
Chances. I can't say I'm flattered.
Thanks already.
You're telling me that's the Archduke's son?
In the flesh. Saw him once when I was your age. He had that same look.
May the blessing of the Phoenix go with you.
What is it now? I told you!
We bear a message for the Viceroy. From the Guardians of the Flame.
Ha! You presume to tell us that a pair of filthy vagabonds, a woman and a dog, could guard aught against the might of the Black Shields? Then come! Die along with your flame! For us area!
For us area!
Your petty revolution ends here. On these our swords we swear.
Slow. Focal.
Imperials aren't taking any chances. I can't say I'm flattered.
Yeah, over here! Go for
this way!
Over here! Go for it!
A noble stand, albeit a misguided one. In taking it, you have but proven our point, that this land is in dire need of cleansing.
Fine hand.
I don't see any more.
Nor do I. The plan worked.
It did. It bloody worked. We sent every last one of the rotten bastards straight to the mud! My, Lord. Perhaps this will be enough to stop the Cullings. For the time being, at least.
Perhaps. Though I doubt my mother will take this loss well. She'll move swiftly to see her minions' ranks replenished.
And then it will all begin again. I often wonder if the nation we once knew is gone for good. Her fields rot. Her people starve. We battled to preserve the flame that was, but for every foe we fell, another springs up in its place. Yet be that as it may, it is still our home, and we must fight for it. As we always have,
and always will.
For as long as the Firebird's flame burns in our hearts, the Duchy cannot die. And her loyal subjects may dream of a day when the Rosarian standard flies over Rosalith once more.
So why you die?
Think we should fall back to Port Isolde before the garrison sends reinforcements? A sound strategy, my lord.
And how long has my uncle been funding you and your comrades' endeavors?
Since the beginning. Lord Byron was the first person I turned to after forming the Guardians. And had I known of this tunnel back then, I wouldn't almost have been hanged by the city guard for trying to sneak over the wall.
I suppose a formal request for an audience would have appeared suspicious.
And appearances must be maintained. Were the Vice Regency to catch wind of Lord Byron's involvement in our movement, they'd seize his estate and send him to the gallows, where he would be of no use to anyone. And so, though it sickens him to the soul, he plays the part of the loyal lord, knowing that one wrong move might prove his downfall. It is why he remains ever vigilant. Don't be surprised if he refuses you an audience, especially since you're famously dead.
Then I will have to think of a way to prove that I am neither wraith nor wrongdoer.
I might have something which could help with the latter. It's the mark of the Guardians. Display it, and those who love Rosaria will know where your loyalties lie.
I shall wear it with pride.
Be sure that you do. I don't want my men attacking you again. Unless you deserve it. If only Sir Tyler could have been here to see you. Or the Lord Commander.
Thank you, Sir Wade. If there is ever anything you need.
I know. Go on now, my lord.
How accommodating. Do you really think they believe we are who we say we are?
Not a chance. All right, I guess. My uncle believes we're imposters here to rob him. And means to string us up himself.
Imagine my surprise when I was told my nephew had come to visit. Clive Rosfield died long ago. And for uttering his name here, you shall pay with your tongue! You would mock me as well.
It is I, Sir Crandall of Camelot, loyal servant to Her Serene Holiness, Saint Sybil the Unshod.
Meadow, thou vile sorcerer, for thy crimes against church and crown, I shall have thy head.
Curse thee, infectious flax wench. Even in death, must thou plague me still? Very well. I shall open the gates of hell, that thou might see thy charge once more.
Bravo, uncle. You're still the finest Maddo in the Twins.
Oh, Clive, my dear boy, it's really you. You always were fond of that scene from The Saint and the Sanctuary. Never did let me play Sir Crandall.
I have a favor to ask, Uncle Byron.
Rutherford, inform the kitchens. There'll be guests. We dine immediately.
But, Uncle...
You can't very well regale me with the tale of your miraculous preservation on an empty stomach. Go on, sit. See that you use the good plates, Rutherford. So you arrived late to one of her cullings, did you? Since becoming Vicerine, Annabella has been a constant thorn in Rosaria's side, but these atrocities are a new low. Something has changed. Quite what? I don't know, but the woman we knew is gone, and a monster sits in her place.
A monster?
For better or worse, I've been charged with governing this town, and thus must maintain the illusion of obedience. That's all I can do to aid Wade and his merry band of revolutionaries.
So he's told us. You have risked much for Rosaria. Our nation will be forever in your debt.
It has been 20 years, Clive. The nation your father and your forefathers fought to defend is no more. Perhaps it would be otherwise had I the courage of my brother. All right, if it's a ship you require, a ship you shall have. I've a galley in port, but recently relieved of her cargo. She can be outfitted for the voyage in a matter of weeks.
So you believe us, then? About everything?
Believe you? Ha! Only a fool would believe even half of the things you claim. But until tonight, only a fool would have believed my nephew still lived. And besides, I have it on good authority that Clive is telling the truth.
Whose authority?
Your own, of course. You've always been a terrible liar.
Is that true?
It's not untrue.
Let's say no more about it, eh? It wouldn't do to linger on my nephew's greatest failing. The one thing I cannot believe, though, is all this about you being Sid. You were always such a good boy, but now you're quite the outlaw. Which, if I'm not mistaken, would make me an outlaw's uncle. Right then, who shall we pillage first? Rutherford, fetch me my cutlass. This will be fun.
She's a fine ship, isn't she?
Once outfitted, she'll bear us across the boiling sea to Drustinus in the space of 3 days.
Something on your mind?
Monsters. When I served the Iron Kingdom, I did so because I saw no other choice. Because once they learned that Lash would not move me, they turned it on those who could. And so I became their puppet. I let them pull my strings, telling myself it was not my hand that swung the sword, but another's. I removed myself from the truth so I wouldn't feel the pain it caused. And before I knew it, I no longer felt anything. Anything at all. I had become a monster.
Jill.
I don't want to be a monster, Clive. Do you understand? I want to choose a different path, a better path. To live on my own terms. But before I can do that, I need to come to terms with my past.
And when you do, I'll be standing there with you, just as you stood with me.
Thank you, Clive. I must atone for my sins. Only then, when it's done, will the monster cease to be.
Just promise me that you won't die with it. Now, let's get some sleep. The journey back to Benamir is long, and there is much to tell the others.
Founder knows what awaits us in the Iron Kingdom, but Vivian could probably make an educated guess.
Deadlands wouldn't be half as bad.
Again, Lord Rosfield. I'm touched that you should find me such good company.
It is not your company, but your counsel that I seek on this occasion.
Ever the charmer. What will it be today, then?
The Iron Kingdom. I need to know what to expect.
You'll soon be setting sail for Drake's Breath, then, I take it. The Mother Crystal that rises from the boiling sea. There was a time when a true-blooded Rosarian had only to brave the waves to visit it. But then the Ironblood made their move. As you know, the Iron Kingdom rules over the islands to the west of Storm. Or rather, its church does. But this is not the pragmatic approach to state religion employed by the Holy Empire to manipulate the masses. No, the Iron Kingdom is the literal embodiment of the crystalline orthodoxy. And so, if one is to understand it, one must start there. As the name implies, the orthodoxy holds the Mother Crystal sacred, and they do not take kindly to heathens plundering the objects of their worship for the means to fill washtubs and light lamps with frivolous feats of magic. Indeed, the faithful consider ether a sinful thing, a poison no less. And to them, a dominant is an instrument of evil, albeit one they have proven only too happy to turn against their enemies. Some 80 years ago, in Northern Storm, Drake's Eye collapsed. Soon after, in pursuit of Aether and with the Blight at their backs, the Northern Territories descended upon the Grand Duchy of Rosaria. And when the Shields of the Flame marched north to meet them, the Iron Kingdom spied an opportunity. A few short days later, the Crusaders landed on the island of Mount Justanus, home of Drake's Breath, and plucked it from the Duchy's grasp. Rosaria tried to reclaim it, of course, but to no avail. I doubt more than a handful of Duchy men have set foot on its shores in your lifetime. Nor are they like to again, under the Empire's stewardship, meaning the Iron Blood will keep their island, and with it, the foothold they need to march on mainland soil when next they spy an opportunity. The Mother Crystal is both the object of the Iron Blood's worship and their gateway to the continent, making Drustanus the holiest of holy grounds, from which the Orthodox Crusade shall one day sail forth to claim the remaining Mother Crystals, or die trying.
My father and my grandfather both traded blows with the Iron Blood for control of Drake's Breath. Had things unfolded differently at Phoenix Gate, we would have sent our entire fleet against them.
But instead, they sent their fleet against Rosaria, sacked the capital, killed the men, and captured the women, including Jill. I'd say you'd be forgiven for wanting a little revenge, Clive.
My only aim is to destroy the Mother Crystal. But thank you all the same. Not much else to do here. Let's see if Jill's ready.
How did we... never hear about these Guardians of the Flame?
Same way they never heard about us, I expect.
There are new billets being posted every day.
Not enough.
It will be over soon.
You ready?
I think so.
Jill. When you told me you had to come to terms with your past, you weren't talking about destroying Drake's Breath, were you?
No. I spoke of Imran, the leader of the Crystalline Orthodox,
The man who made me do all those unspeakable things. I'm going to kill him. It's what I need to do to put the past behind me. What I need to move forward. And I know that I can do it. If you're there beside me.
Always.
And I'll be beside you, too. We'll bring down the Mother Crystal together. All while Cid looks on.
We'll make him proud. Useful trick. Freezing and thawing the spray to make mist. How did you learn to use your powers like this?
The Masters made me do it. When the Crusaders took to the seas, to keep the fleet's movements from prying eyes. I'm fine.
No, you're not.
This may be the only chance I get to go back. My only chance to put things right. I have to do this. Whatever the cost.
All right.
She is. The Iron Kingdom's Mother Crystal.
Drake's breath. Strong currents, sharp rocks, and ether floods. Let's not forget them. This island is a natural fortress.
But safety breeds complacency, allowing a single rowing boat to slip in unseen. The sanctuary is inside the mountain. If we follow the old trail, we should be able to enter by the back gate.
All right. Let's go. I always imagined when I came here it would be to reclaim it.
It used to belong to Rosaria, didn't it?
Once, though it's been in the Ironblood's clutches for far too long.
As was I. For 13 years, this rock was my home. I know its secrets only too well. This path was abandoned after an ether flood. They don't guard it.
The perfect little shortcut.
Leave the
that must have spread. It was never as bad as this before. And the only way past them is through them.
Get him!
Was that an earthquake?
They happen all the time. That wasn't even a bad one. It's nothing to worry about.
This one. Sick of it!
Look at this place. What a mess.
Wait.
Attack! Get him! You're here!
this one.
Over here!
This one!
Kinslow!
Get him! Get him! This one! Second! Get him! This one! Second!
Over here!
Get him!
Press on?
Yes. It's like a furnace in here.
We're inside the volcano. You get used to the heat. Though I don't remember it being quite this hot.
Was that one cause for concern?
It was. And they're getting bigger. Something's wrong.
Get him!
Is there no other way across?
Do that again.
No. Let's not. They don't look too tough.
Perhaps not with them, but in numbers like these. Attack! Going this way.
Let's look for another path. Drake's breath.
We're nearly at the oratory.
This one! Go for it!
Sick of it. doing?
Nothing good, I'll wager.
Over here!
Thank you.
Quite a commotion our friend made. Let's hope the guards didn't hear it.
The gate to the inner chambers is just up there. Then we make for the sanctuary. I need to finish this before the heat finishes me.
Hear, hear.
We'll enter the Comrick by the Handmaiden's living quarters. It was always a hive of activity.
Sounds like we'll have a hard time staying out of sight.
We won't have to. There's someone there I should very much like to see.
Lady Marley, it's me.
By some mother. Jill, it can't be.
It is, my lady.
We cannot talk here. Come with me.
I'm so glad you're safe.
And I you.
Why ever would you risk coming back? Are you a fool, girl? Or have you grown tired of your freedom already?
Forgive me, my lady. But I had to come back. There are things I left undone. Tell me, where is the Patriarch?
At this hour, he'll be in the Comrick, giving thanks.
You mean... Oh, fiend! Clive, we have to get to the Sanctuary. Now! Lady Marley, you must flee this place. Gather your things and go.
Now listen here, Jill.
Inelak, Lord!
We have company.
This way. Follow this passage. It leads straight to the Comrick. Go on, stop dawdling.
Thank you. You were always so kind to me. My light in the darkness. Take care, my lady, please. You deserve better than this. A long and happy life, promise me.
Promise to do the same.
Come on, Clive. We're nearly at the Comrick.
All right.
Are there?
last one.
Clive, there's something I need to know. I saw the Patriarch do things no one should have to see. And so I swore that he would die by my hand.
I understand. I faced my demons, and you must face yours.
Big stall, second.
I needed that.
Shiva's dominant. Come to beg forgiveness for your failure.
For years I followed your orders. Fought your wars. All to protect the children you took. Just as you took me. And what did you do in return? You slit their throats!
Fiend.
Their souls were sullied with a stain of ether. I merely cleansed them of their corruption. A penance paid. Just as the Holy Mother wills it! Repent! Abomination! For a monster like you to set foot in the Holy Cymmrich is in itself a crime deserving of death!
You're right. I am a monster. And my soul is stained black. Though not by ether. But by the evil of men like you, who made me close my heart and drown in darkness when I should have raged against it! This is my penance. I will be your monster no more. Nor will I suffer you to create another.
Does the beast bare its teeth at its master? Come then, Dominant. Rage, be as you have ever been. A monster!
And what are you, Imran? I was forced to kill. You do it by choice. But never again. I bowed to you once. Now it is you who shall bow to me!
Kill them.
Now!
Right! Do it!
Ugh! I won't take long.
this one.
Come on!